Hello dear students, once again welcome to Meet Science class. Now I am going to start a new topic, that is meat processing. So earlier we have talked in four different parts about the preservation of meat. Today I am going to start a new topic, meat processing. This will be discussed in three different parts. So today I am going to talk some of the basic aspects of meat processing, and then in the second part I will talk exclusively on comminuted meat products, and in the third part I will be talking about non-comminuted meat products and indigenous meat products. So let us understand first what is processing. Processing refers to any treatment including addition of salt, and when it brings any kind of physical and chemical changes to the natural state of meat. So processing means any such process which makes physical and chemical changes. So in that sense, adding salt is also a kind of processing. But the normal meat plant operations like cutting of meat or trimming of meat or deboning, that is removing the meat from the bones or separating the bones or simply grinding, these are not considered as meat processing. Processing invariably improves shelf life of meat. So in earlier days when there was no proper preservation methods, those days different kind of meat preservation evolved with the pursuit of preserving the meat. So what is the purpose of meat processing? As I said, in the earlier days, one of the purpose or one of the major purpose was for the preservation of meat. But in today, with the development of refrigeration, so preservation of meat is easy by refrigeration or by freezing. So nowadays, or in the modern context, processing means to develop some new product, some new variety with different new flavor, and to increase the marketing and demand for the consumers. In India, only about 3 to 4% of total meat is processed into products, whereas in developed countries it is quite higher. In case of US, it is about 30% of the total meat produced by them. Now the meat processing can be classified into different subcategories. One of the most common is the comminuted meat products. Comminuted means when the meat is ground into smaller particles. That is called comminuted. So those are the most common products like sausages, nuggets, patties, balls. Then there is non-comminuted meat product, where the meat is not ground into pieces or the normal structure of the muscle remains as such. So most popular in that category is ham and bacon. Then there is restructured meat product, where the meat is not ground but cut into pieces and made into a new form or new structure, which is sometimes made for ham and bacon also from the boneless meat, or chops, cutlets, etc. And then there is another category, miscellaneous, where again sometimes they are non-comminuted like barbecue, tandoori and kebab, which are Indian origin popular meat products. So we are going to discuss all these type of meat products in the three different parts. Now before we go to those specific type of products, specifically I want to discuss about cooking, because cooking is one of the important process for making the meat suitable for eating. So in that sense, it is also a kind of processing. So earlier I have discussed thermal processing of meat, or which is also called as canning. So what is the importance of cooking? Cooking makes changes in color and makes it more attractive brown color. It increases the digestibility by denaturation and coagulation of proteins. this is a spelling mistake, T-E-I-N-S. It increases the flavor by the interaction of different components like protein and fat, protein and carbohydrate due to the high temperature. It causes hydrolysis of collagen, that is in the lot of connective tissue present in the meat that get converted to collagen and it becomes more soft and tender. And this cooking process also increases the shelf life by reducing the moisture and by killing the microbes. So that is how cooking is very important, and it is one of the important processing of meat to get it different kind of taste, flavor and different kind of dishes. Now there is different level of cooking or intensity. Sometimes we call it doneness. So there is rare done, which is 58 to 60 degrees Celsius, which will have pink color. There is medium done, 66 to 68 degrees Celsius, which is be little more darker. Then medium done, 73 to 75 degrees Celsius, that will be brownish or grayish. And well done, 80 to 82 degrees Celsius, there it will be brown or gray color. So this temperature indicates the internal temperature. After cooking, the internal temperature should reach this temperature. Now we will talk about methods of cooking. Basically, cooking is done by three different category or classified into three different category, that is dry heat cooking, moist heat cooking and a modern microwave cooking. So moist heat cooking, there will be presence of steam or water. There will be presence of steam or water. And it has got very high heat efficiency and very high impact on the pathogens or microbes. And it helps in making the tough meat tender. The dry cooking, where the actual temperature may be high, but there is no presence of water or steam or water vapor. So this is suitable for tender cuts or ground meat, that is once it is already minced and made into some products. In that case, dry cooking. So there will be no moisture or steam present. Here you can see the different name of different kind of cooking, which I am going to discuss again. So here you can see the different kind of cooking methods and their suitability for different cuts. I am not going to discuss it in much details. Here you can see the braising, stewing, these are moist cooking, whereas roasting, smoking, dry cooking. Then we have boiling, simmering, steaming, these are all moist cooking, whereas grilling, sauteing, searing, frying, broiling, these are all dry cooking. So each method indicated for different kind of meat and their suitability. Now we will talk more details about the moist heat cooking. So moist heat cooking examples are boiling. So if we put the meat in water and boil, or stewing, we can put little bit of moisture and cook it in a cooker, that is stewing. There is pressure cooking, that is in a high pressure we use the pressure cooker, which will have very high impact in tenderizing the tough meat. And there is another one, braising, where there will be both dry and moist cooking combined. Sometime we can call it roasting also. So this moist cooking is very suitable for tough cuts. The meat cuts which are very tough, that can be made into soft by using the moist heat cooking. Hot water or steam is continuously kept in contact with the meat. In case of moist cooking, the hot water or steam will be with the meat. And in this case, loss of moisture will be less and the yield of the final product will be more. Pressure cooking, stewing, simmering, etc. are very popular moist cooking methods. And in Indian condition, pressure cooking is very popular because most of the other meat except broiler are coming from the older animals and they are quite tough. Here the higher temperature with pressure facilitates the tenderization of the tough cuts of meat. In pressure cooking, the temperature goes beyond 100 degree. It can reach up to 120 degrees Celsius due to the high pressure, and that helps in tenderizing the tough meat cuts. So stewing or braising. Here stewing meat pieces are first browned in small amount of fat or oil. So first there will be a little bit of frying with fat and oil, and then some water is added and cooked further, preferably by putting the lid. So in case of simmering, it involves cooking in hot water at a lower temperature. Simmering is also a moist cooking with water, but at a lower temperature. Braising is more common in Indian condition, where the meat, even other vegetables or potato, everything is fried first, and then some condiments and all are added and fried again, and then water is added along with other seasonings and cooked at a higher temperature. That is called braising. In case of dry heat cooking, most common are roasting, grilling and frying. So more cooking losses happens in case of frying, because it is done at a high temperature and in presence of oil. So oil will have a very high temperature, at least 130-150 degrees Celsius, and in that case the loss of moisture is more. And in case of roasting and microwave, it is little bit better in maintaining the nutritive values, or the loss of nutrients are comparatively less, whereas in case of frying, the loss of nutrients will be more, but the flavor will be better. So roasting is suitable for tender cuts like pork shoulder and loin, lamb shoulder and loin, and cured ham. Here the temperature in hot air oven, roasting is preferably done in hot air oven at a temperature of around 150 degrees Celsius. It generally gives good browning. In case of roasting, the brown color happens and flavor will be good. Then frying. This is another most common dry heat cooking method. It is suitable for thin cuts of meat such as sliced steaks, mutton chops, chicken meat pieces, etc. It can be deep frying, like here in the large amount of oil is used, or it can be shallow frying in case of pan with less amount of oil. In both the cases, it gives excellent flavor, but there will be lot of loss of moisture, so yield will be less, and due to very high temperature, it will damage some of the nutrients. So loss of nutrients can happen. But the shelf life of such meat will be better. Now the third category of cooking is microwave cooking. This is comparatively modern or newer method. So microwaves are actually high frequency non-ionizing electromagnetic waves. So these electromagnetic waves are produced inside the oven in a vacuum tube, or which is called as magnetron, and these microwaves are operated at around 950 megahertz commonly, sometime 2200 level of megahertz are also used, but most commonly domestic microwave cookers use 950 megahertz. So this microwave penetrates into the food particle from all directions. So food means there will be water, fat, sugar, protein, etc. So these microwaves will penetrate into the food particles from all directions at a very high speed. And because of that, it will cause a very high vibrations into the molecules, leading to a very high friction. So because of the penetration of the microwave, it will cause a very huge vibrations leading to friction of molecules, and that produces heat and causing the cooking. So cooking happens due to this heat of friction. In this case, the spread of heat happens throughout the space inside the oven or inside the food itself. So that's why it is also called as volume heating. Here the cooking is very fast, so it saves a lot of time. But only thing is, this microwave can pass through glass, pottery, wood and paper material. But any container with metals, it cannot pass through. So any metal container is not suitable for microwave cooking. Any metal like steel or brass, all such containers are not suitable for microwave cooking. And in this case, one of the limitations is, it will not give proper browning, and it needs frequent turning. In between you have to stop, turn it and run again. But nowadays sometime there is a browning facility, but that is again not very good. Now that was the basic background about the meat processing. Now next we are going to talk about comminuted meat products. As I already told earlier, the comminuted means the particle size is reduced. The particle size of meat is reduced. That is, meat is cut into very small pieces. So this process helps in extraction of salt-soluble proteins, and which binds with other meat ingredients together and gives a new structure. Now this helps in distribution of fat and connective tissue uniformly. Because of the grinding and mixing thoroughly, the fat and connective tissue is very uniformly distributed along with the muscle tissues, I mean the particles. So this grinding is done by two stages. First, it is done with the help of a mincer that gives a coarse grinding, and in the second stage it is done in a bowl chopper, which is also called a silent cutter or fine cutting machine, and in which a emulsion is made for different kind of products to be prepared. So after this emulsion is made, this can be used for many different kind of products can be prepared from this batter or emulsion. So what are the ingredients for making comminuted meat products? So main ingredient is the meat, that is the primary ingredient, and its functional properties varies according to the composition. So mainly skeletal muscle is very important, but sometimes low value cuts and organ meats are also added, and that reduces the cost of the product, but such meat will have very low functional properties. So we should not use too much of these low value cuts or organ meats, because skeletal muscle has got very good binding abilities. So different kind of meat has got different level of binding abilities. So to hold the different particles of muscles and fat and water together, binding ability or emulsifying ability of meat protein is very important. So high quality meat should be there to a major extent, and the other parts, low value cuts or other organ meat, should be at a lower proportion. Now there is non-meat ingredients. In this case, most important is water. Water helps in mixing the different ingredients, in dissolving some of the ingredients, and in distribution of ingredients. Water also plays important role in temperature control, and it gives the juiciness and yield for the product, final product, because we are going to add extra water from outside. Mostly we add it in the form of ice or chilled water. The other ingredients, like curing ingredients, which we have discussed during curing and smoking section, like salt, sugar, phosphate, nitrite, they have got important roles. Like salt, sugar, both has got preservative effect and flavor effect. Phosphate is antioxidant, nitrite gives flavor and excellent color. Then there is another category called binders, fillers and extenders. They are used for improving the emulsion stability, water holding capacity, juiciness, flavor, and increasing the bulk, and also as a binder or extender. Then the last category is seasonings. These are mainly to add additional flavor. This depends on our choice or preferences. So in Indian condition, we always add onion, ginger, garlic paste. Whereas in Western condition, they add only pepper or sometimes only mustard. In India, we add a lot of different kind of dry spices in the form of a mix. Sometimes we can add MSG, that is monosodium glutamate, which gives a typical flavor. Now here are the basic processing steps for comminuted meat products. In the next lecture, I am going to talk about the details about different kind of comminuted products. But today I am talking only about the basic steps. So there is comminution, that is cutting or grinding into particles. Then there is emulsification. Then extension, that is addition of binders and emulsifiers. Then forming, that is making shape. then smoking, it is sometime may or may not be there, but cooking will be there, and packing. So here you can see the flow chart. The frozen meat is taken, then it will be semi-thawed and cut into pieces, then mincing will be done, then it will be fine mincing and mixing will be done in bowl chopper, then salt, sugar, phosphate along with water, the machine will be run and protein will be extracted, then it makes a semi-solid slurry, then the fats or oils are added and mixed and we get a emulsion. After that the condiments, spices and binders are added and finally we get a batter. I'm going to explain it further. So comminuted product means comminution. Comminution means subdivision or cutting into smaller particles. I have already told. First it is done with the mincer, which gives coarse particles, and further fine particles are done in bowl chopper. In the next slide I am going to show. This is the mincer where the boneless meat, semi-frozen, cut into pieces and passed through, and it gives a grinding. And here it helps in uniform distribution of other ingredients and reduces the toughness. So because of the cutting into smaller particles, we can mix everything uniformly along with the fat and other ingredients or flavoring agents or other additives or extenders, and the toughness of meat is gone due to the cutting into smaller pieces. Here there is a bowl which rotates in a horizontally in a slow speed, and there are knives which rotates vertically in a high speed. I am going to show it next. So that is the emulsion which is made here in the bowl chopper, which is also called as silent cutter, where there is both cutting and chopping and mixing takes place. So actually emulsion means it is the mixture of two immiscible liquids, where one liquid is dispersed into another. So naturally there is two phases. One is called continuous phase, another is called dispersed phase. So in case of meat, the dispersed phase is solid or liquid fat droplets, whereas the continuous phase is a matrix of water, salts and protein. So it's a semi-solid slurry prepared by the extraction of proteins during the chopping in the bowl chopper. So in that sense, it is not a true emulsion, it is a pseudo-emulsion. So meat emulsion is an oil in water emulsion. That is, the oil particle or fat particle is dispersed into the matrix. So oil in water emulsion, where soluble proteins act as emulsifiers. So meat emulsion, meat is chopped. First the minced meat is put here, then the salt, sugar, phosphate, curing ingredients along with chilled water, it is chopped in a very high speed, and that causes extraction of proteins and it makes a semi-solid slurry. Now the fat particle size of the fat will be above 50 micron here. And after this high speed mixing, first the proteins are extracted and slurry is made, then the fat is added and again high speed mixing happens. At that time fat particles get mixed with the slurry and it forms a emulsion. Here the temperature is very, very important. So that's why the ice flake is used or very chilled water is used to absorb the heat, and temperature should remain around 15 degrees Celsius or below. So here is the final emulsion. So lean meat is better for making good emulsion. Lean meat means where there is less amount of fat, only good quality muscle, that is called lean meat. And salt soluble proteins have high emulsifying capacity. So earlier I have told, when I was talking about different kinds of protein, that is actin and myosin especially, or the myofibrillar proteins, they are the salt soluble proteins. So when we are running the machine along with the minced meat and salt and water and chopping it in a very high speed, that time the salt soluble proteins, that is mainly the myofibrillar proteins, will come out and it makes the slurry, and that helps in making the emulsion by capturing the fat particle. So this is the histological structure of the meat emulsion, where you can see these are the fat droplets and it is coated with soluble proteins which is extracted now. So the every fat droplet is coated with protein matrix, and surrounding that there will be other muscle fibers and connective tissue fibers. And all other ingredients will be thoroughly mixed up, and it makes an excellent homogeneous uniform mixture. Now this is the meat emulsion or batter. Now this can be filled into casing or filled into molds and heated. When it is heated directly, at least around 55 to 60 degrees Celsius, so immediately this outer coating of protein will be denatured and it holds the fat droplets inside. Now after that, further cooking happens, so the entire batter get a uniform texture and a very nice feeling for eating or texture of the product. So here the other ingredients, that is meat extenders, as I told already, meat, non-meat food items, that those are added. Those are also called as extenders. Specifically, they are called as fillers, binders or emulsifiers. So fillers means soy proteins, potato starch or some kind of flours like wheat, rice, pea, corn. These are called as fillers. Binders means milk products like skim milk powder, whey protein concentrate or sodium caseinate. They are classified as binders. And the emulsifiers like sodium alginate, carrageenan, gum acacia or gum arabic, these are all considered as emulsifier. But altogether, for a common understanding, we call them the meat extenders or binders. So they have a lot of important role in making a good batter and holding the water, giving the yield and increasing the bulk and producing a very nice texture. So now there is the final steps. That is, the batter is ready. Now the next step is forming. So if we want to make sausage, it is filled into the casing and it gets a shape. If we want to make a nuggets, we want to put it in the mold and then it is cooked either in steam or hot water. If we want to make loaf, it will be filled into mold and cooked in dry oven. Patties means, again, it is molded and cooked in dry grilling oven. Sometime there will be smoking. If we want special kind of flavor, there will be smoking. So in case of sausage, directly there will be both smoking and cooking. So first it will undergo smoking, then it will be cooked with steam. Nowadays there are combined ovens where both smoking and cooking happens. So cooking is very, very important for fixing that texture of the emulsion. That is, the protein should be coagulated and the fat should be held together. So this can be done sometime in a combined method, but mostly comminuted products we can do it in steaming and smoking. Sometime dry heat, like in case of patties or loaf, there will be dry heat is required. Or nowadays even microwave cooking is also possible. Now after this, finally there is quality evaluation. So once the product is ready, we must monitor the quality. As I told earlier, there are mainly three aspects in quality. One is organoleptic, one is microbial, another is chemical. So organoleptic evaluation, I am going to talk in more details how to do that. This is to ascertain the eating quality or the taste of the product. So there is specific techniques and methods to evaluate. Microbial evaluation for food safety, I have already discussed earlier, like total microbial counts or presence of any pathogens. All these things need to be monitored, which we are going to discuss in practical sessions. And there is some chemical evaluation like TBA, tyrosine, free fatty acid. These are sometimes more important for monitoring the storage quality of meat products. So when we want to store the meat product for long time, then we have to intermittently monitor these microbial quality and chemical evaluation also. Even organoleptic evaluation also we should do. So once the product is ready, it has to be packed and kept properly, and we should check time to time if at all there is any damage to the packaging. So this is about the basic processing technique for the meat processing. So today I have discussed some of the basic aspect. The next class I will discuss only about the comminuted meat products, and in the third lecture I will talk about the non-comminuted meat products and some of the popular indigenous meat products. So I wish you all to thoroughly read from the printed notes I have given. There it is specifically divided into community and meat products and non-community and meat products. So please listen to this lecture and read the printed notes. That will make everything very clear. Thank you. Thank you for watching this, and I will be back with the next lecture shortly.